You know, I'm very glad to see so many people here for this address about county government. There really is a very dry topic. There's nothing funny about it, unless, of course, you use the airport circle, then it becomes a... That's not our fault, by the way. That was only the first leg. They were supposed to close down Amelia Earhart. They didn't. And that's a whole nother speech. I wish to thank the chamber for giving me the opportunity to discuss the state of Atlantic County government. County government is one of the four branches. Now, I'm going to sound condescending right now, but when you consider this last election, we had 60-some percent of the electorate come out and vote. Prior to that, in 15, we had about 20-some percent. So obviously, government is not in the forefront of people's minds, except for the entertainment value that this last election was, and it most certainly was entertaining, and it looks like it's even going to be more so as time goes on. But as a school teacher, it's very important that you define your terms. And when I would teach the Civil War as a history teacher, I would interchange terms. And I would say the Union, or the United States, or the Yankees, or the North. There are four terms that really are interchangeable. And with the South, the CSA, the Confederacy, the Rebels, and talking to students that are not up to snuff with the war itself, it can be very, very confusing. So just what is county government, and what does it do? Before we get there, let me just make something very clear. Our founding fathers never promised us efficient government. They promised us government that would serve the people and be very close to the people. And that's what we got. When this country was first founded, it was brought about because of taxation without representation. You can imagine if they came back today and saw what taxation is with representation, they would wonder what they fought for. You have four layers of government. You have your federal government, of course. You have your state government. You have your county governments, and you have your municipal governments. Then we go back into terms again. Your municipal government, you are either living in a borough or a town or a township or a city, but they're all municipalities, and they all have the power to tax you. And they all do. And unfortunately, in the state of New Jersey, they tax us considerably. We have all of these entities here, and just look at taxes as a pair of pants with four pockets and somebody reaching their hand into each one of them. As you well know, our area faces some significant challenges, but at the same time, we also face significant opportunities. And that's what I want to discuss with you today, just what the future holds. Now, when we talk about our government, just county government itself, people expect us to make sure the potholes are filled. By the way, we have 375 miles of county roads here in Atlantic County. That doesn't count your state highways or your municipal roads. Now, that 375 may not mean a whole lot to you, but when I tell you that we're responsible for more miles of roads than the parkway, the expressway, and the New Jersey Turnpike put end on end, then it seems to take some type of a form that you can understand the responsibilities that we have. Our road department goes out this last snowstorm, and you know, because I told you how inefficient the system is, you'll see a plow going down the street with the shovel up. Why is that? Well, it's obviously a municipal plow on a county road or a state plow on a municipal road, and of course, never the twain meets. Not a very efficient way to do things. But nevertheless, I'm the messenger, and I'm just letting you know how things work. We're responsible for mosquito units. We're responsible for community college, the special services school district, the vocational school. We have a road department, of course, that fills potholes, plows the streets, and of course, a multitude of responsibilities. And many people don't know what county government does until they need us. And when they need us, of course, it's either because of adult services that we have, or our nursing home, or our Meals on Wheels. These are all things that come under our purview. Over the years, you've heard me say that Atlanta County is the best run county in the state. Got to say that regardless. Infrequently do we have proof of it, besides asking my mother, what do you think about the job your son's doing? But we do have Moody's Investment Service that came out very recently, just last month. Despite the financial issues and uncertainty plaguing Atlantic City, the county has maintained structural balances and demonstrated strong governance. It's pretty good when an investment service talks about how good your government is. The county has shown a remarkable degree of budgeting accuracy, closely matching annual operating revenues to expenses. In fact, since 2009, appropriation reserves have annually contributed an average of $3.6 million to adjusted fund balance, or 15.5% of the total. Now, what the hell does that mean? What Moody's saying is that Atlanta County is doing something you don't see being done too often, especially at the state and the federal level. In other words, we're spending less than we take in. Moody goes on to say the county's contingency planning has primarily turned on the uncertainty in Atlantic City. In doing so, the county has attempted to balance its financial needs with avoiding overtaxing its other municipalities. As Moody's notes, despite extremely uncertain economic times, county government has been able to stabilize our finances and taxes. But however, there are three areas that are beating us up that we have no control over. The first, if you were like me when you went to the polls a few years ago, you voted for bail reform, and so did I. But of course, the devil's in the details. It will cost us, this year alone, $800,000, and that will grow. And we didn't really need it here in the county. We've reduced our jail population from 1,200 to 700 because we cared. We stopped people, locking people up for fourth-degree crimes and having them rot in jail. And when you do hear these horror stories about people, well, they're in jail for 6 months because they had a joint in their pocket, or because of simple shoplifting of a $4 item, that's not the Superior Court. That's your municipal court. But the bail reform does not apply to municipal court. It applies to Superior Court judges, which, by the way, everyone has to have their hearing within 48 hours. Now think about that for a moment. 48 hours. So now we need more judges, more prosecutors, more staff, more benefits, more everything to make sure that we comply with the state order. By the way, if you're interested in who else does this, the state of Kentucky does it. The only other state in the union. So somebody in Trenton decided that sounds like a good idea. I tell my staff, look for ways to save money, will you please? Stop spending. It seems in Trenton, they just look for ways to spend more money. When was the last time they came up with an idea? Gee, let's cut taxes here. Aren't you sick of hearing people that move from here and go to North Carolina and tell you, gee, I'm living on a lake. I got a four-bedroom house, 2.5 baths, and I'm paying $600 a year in property tax. You've heard it as much as I have. Well, why isn't it done here? And by the way, we are successful in this county. And one of the reasons we are, is because we emulate the counties that have done things right. We don't have to reinvent the wheel. Unfortunately, the state of New Jersey has the I guess, the highest tax state in the country. I've made that comment a few times, and somebody in the crowd will usually correct me and say, oh, no, it's Connecticut or New York. Okay, so we're 47th or 48th on the list. Does that make you feel better? But that also fluctuates. Also, something we ought to think about, which is really all we can do is think about it, because now it's law, the pilot legislation. That pilot legislation is probably the worst crafted legislation anyone has ever seen, but it passed and got the governor's signature. We agreed to it, providing we got at least 13.5% of the $120 million that the casinos will be paying. By the way, what the casinos give back for that $120 million is the fact that they will not challenge their assessment for 10 years, which means their assessment, their property assessments will not increase for 10 years, which means they won't pay any more taxes for 10 years. Now, the taxes in Atlantic City just went up 16%. Every non-casino taxpayer is going to pay it, except the casinos. That's how it goes. All we want is our fair share. And by the way, we're told now that we have to negotiate with Atlantic City for the fair share. Does anybody find that unusual? Atlantic City is now taken over. It's a ward of the state. The state will make every single financial decision in the city of Atlantic City, except for one. How much the county is going to get, we should be negotiating with the city itself. If that's the case, why aren't they negotiating with Atlantic City instead of taking it over? Property tax refunds, by the way. The pilot is just from 2015 on. So 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 are not included. So all those tax refunds are going to are not included. From 2007 to 2016, Atlanta County has had to refund $51.7 million back to Atlantic City. And this year, by the way, we have to return another $12.7 million. Because they've overassessed their properties. What the city had done historically was, when things were very good, they would just tax the casinos. Gee, we have budgetary needs. We've hired every friend and relative that we know. So who's going to pay for it? The casinos. So we'll overtax them to meet our needs in the city. Unfortunately, now the casinos are saying the chickens just came home to roost. We want our money back. And of course, they won. And you can't really blame them. They were smarter than we were. By the way, don't blame county government. We were told in court we have no standing. We're only a pass-through. And we have also no power over the assessment in any municipality, not just Atlantic City. That's why I've been calling for years and years for a countywide assessment. We wouldn't have to need for a pilot. But it is what it is. By the way, that's a total of $64.4 million we have to give back. And if you can calculate, for every $3 million, that's 1 cent on your tax rate. Now, with that said, you know, to quote Whitman, I'm not here to tell you pleasant things. I'm here to tell you truths. And it is not as bad as it seems. In fact, we are the master of our destiny. For those of you that took philosophy, you'll know that the Stoics said there's nothing you can do to change fate. Well, there is. You don't have to listen to the Stoics. Later on, philosophers, Nietzsche for one, made it very, very clear that fate is questionable, that the free will power that we have can change things. In other words, was everybody's time up at when the Twin Towers went down? Don't think so. Can you change certain things? Well, if you know there's heart disease in your family and you exercise and you don't eat fatty foods and you keep your weight down, you can at least alter it for a period of time. And that's what we're going to do. We are going to be in the forefront right now, Atlanta County government. Why? Because we can. Well, why are you doing it now? Well, we tried to do this years ago and it didn't work out. In fact, we can go so far back as when Ken Lefevre was a freeholder and assemblyman, tried to put together something like this back then. It didn't work out. And why didn't it? because you didn't have to. We were making money hand over fist. Everybody was working. This was a bonanza here. So consequently, when things change, now we're saying to ourselves, well, look what Atlantic City did. They never reinvented themselves. They should have had more attractions. They should have made it a family resort. That way of thinking is why we're in the mess we're in. Atlantic City is not Atlantic County. Atlantic City is a city that's extremely important, but it's only 48 blocks long. We have a whole county that we have to worry about and think about that we want to see not only survive, but thrive. The prosperity that we had, and you remember the buses coming in bumper to bumper, they gave people $25, $50 just to come into a casino. They gave you free meals, free rooms, free everything. You couldn't make money fast enough. Kids weren't going to college because they went and became dealers or pit bosses. And they were making $40, $50, $60, $100,000 a year. It would never end. But it did. That all changed virtually overnight. It became clear that the economic development efforts in place at the time were inadequate in relation to our needs. They were too disjointed. They lacked coordination, too dependent on state rather than local leadership. There was no guiding strategy or plan. Goals and priorities frequently changed as elected officials changed. The consequence of this is that we face the economic challenges that we do today. First and foremost, because we failed to diversify our economy and attract new businesses and industries. When the gaming industry declined, there was nothing else here to keep things in balance. As Angelou Economics, this was the firm that we hired, noted in their report, our over-reliance on one economic sector to the near exclusion of all others is a serious threat to our long-term economic well-being. So we decided to put our money where our mouth is. After all, Atlantic City right now has a junk rating. The state of New Jersey has been downgraded at least 10 times in the last 7 years. So we're going to do it. But you know, everybody, success does have risks. We put quite a bit of our money into our future here in economic development. And we could do that because we had the lowest debt ratio of any county in the state of New Jersey. So we're in a position to get into the forefront. Why? Because we have been frugal. And one thing a politician has to learn to do is say no. As you know, if you read the newspapers or listened to the news, it was a public fight that I had with our sheriff who wanted a raise. Wasn't going to occur on my watch. Not saying he wasn't deserving, not saying he didn't do a good job. But I gave my employees 3-day furlough days without pay. I wasn't going to give somebody at the top a raise. I had to say no to the NAACP when they came in, asking for $600,000 for Brown Park in Atlantic City on Bacharach Boulevard. The answer was no. And of course, the veterans organizations, don't you have respect for the memory of Sergeant Brown? Yes, I do. In fact, I have great respect for all of our veterans. But the answer is still no. And that's why we're in the position today. Just two examples, and just the ones that come to my mind, why we can finance what we're doing. And by the way, it is our tax money. And we most certainly are going to watch over it very carefully, but we have to take that step out. Now everything is changing. We have a comprehensive economic development strategy and action plan in place. We have targeted 5 strategic industries best suited for Atlanta County: gaming and tourism, hospitality, aviation, light manufacturing, and life sciences. Areas such as, biomedicine, pharmaceuticals, and of course, entrepreneurship. We're going to get this done, and we've already started. Most important, we've established an independent economic development corporation, the Atlanta County Economic Alliance. For the first time, we have an entity exclusively focused on attracting and retaining businesses and promoting all of Atlanta County as a place to live and work. The ACEA is up and running with offices located at Hamilton Mall and serves as a single point of entry for economic development assistance. Without such an entity, we will always be at a competitive disadvantage with competing communities that have one. And I'd like to thank Leo Schofer, the interim chairman, for his extraordinary efforts. Thank you, Leo. Along with many, many other people that are here. I told Carlo Lasco, I'm not going to mention his name because I don't want to offend everybody, but he is also a part of it. As I mentioned earlier, our conservative financial management practices have enabled us to support some critical economic development initiatives. The significance of this was noted in Moody's report. During the good times, we maintain one of the lowest debt ratios of any county. In the last year, we put our debt capacity to good use by supporting two economic development projects that were identified by our consultant as critical to getting the local economy back on track. These projects are the Stockton Gateway Project in Atlantic City and the first building of the Aviation Research and Technology Park. Yeah, it finally came to fruition. Construction of the $210 million Gateway Project began last summer. It includes a new Stockton University campus and South Jersey Gas headquarters on and around the former Atlantic City High School site. At Stockton's Beach campus, 1,800 students daily will use the academic building. 500 students will live on site, walking the streets, using the nearby park, and of course mingling with the 200 from South Jersey Gas. If you want an investment, that whole area right there, it will be symbiotic. That'll be alive and well, that Chelsea area around the high school. Think about it. All of these students, all of these people, it will be alive and well, and that's just the beginning. Atlantic County stepped up and helped to make this happen by using the county's strong bond rating to assist in financing this project. When it's completed in August of 2018, it will transform the Chelsea section of the city and be a catalyst for additional development. The Stockton portion of the project was funded by a $127 million bond issued by our Improvement Authority and backed by Stockton University, county government, and ERG, Economic Redevelopment and Growth Funds, that is, tax credits. No county property taxpayer money will be used to pay the debt service of this project. Perhaps the most significant economic development project is now underway in the development of the Aviation Research and Technology Park. The aviation sector offers Atlantic County the most immediate opportunity for growth. It builds on the work being done at the FAA Tech Center. Why wouldn't you? The Hughes Center is one of the premier facilities in the country. Why wouldn't we want to tap into this? Well, I've been saying it for years, and it falls on deaf ears. And as my mother would say, the good Lord helps those who help themselves. You know, asking the federal government, asking the state government, will you do it? Yeah, yeah, it's a great idea. Nothing happened. We're doing it. And you're going to see results and super results. The aviation sector offers Atlantic County the most immediate opportunity for growth. It builds on the work being done already at the Tech Center. New Jersey is designated as one of the six FAA-designated test regions for unmanned air vehicles. And as I stated on numerous occasions, it's not our goal to develop an aviation research park as an end of itself. It's a goal to get a strong aviation industry established here. Work is currently underway on phase one of the project, which includes site drainage, parking lots, sidewalks, curbing, and outside electrical. This week, bids will be going out for phase two, which consists of 60,000 square foot building. We plan the actual construction to begin in March. This project is also financed through our Atlantic County Improvement Authority with, of course, our county support. That authority has going to be tapped to do a whole lot. This is us, ladies and gentlemen, helping ourselves. Successful development of the park is vital because we need to attract skilled workers who will be paid good salaries and benefits. Now, right now, what are we arguing over? Whether we should have $8 minimum wage or a $15 minimum wage? You're still not going to be able to pay your rent with it. These are good, solid jobs that will bring people into our area to buy the homes, to take these homes that are underwater, and we can really do something to make this area thrive. It's a wonderful place to live. You know, we mentioned Atlantic City. It's still the top chefs, the top restaurants, the top entertainment in the world. You'll see the casinos every single weekend. They're mobbed. People want to come here. They want to live here. They want to recreate here. This is what we have to offer. And by the way, we're still the third largest venue for casino gaming in the country, behind Nevada and Pennsylvania. All is not as devastating as you will have people say it is. We just have to have a positive thought process. And believe me, it is catching. It's infectious. We have to all believe in this area, especially you all, you stakeholders. You're here because you care. This is a Chamber of Commerce luncheon. And that's what it's all about, business. As John Kennedy said, a rising tide raises all boats. Our future is rosy, and we're going to do it. We're going to get it done, but we're going to need your help. This is going to be in the private sector. All I know from government, it's always been in the way. As Ronald Reagan said, government is the problem. We can't get out of our own way. And if this bail reform isn't an example of what it is, and the pilot another example of what it is, and we can go on and on. Let's go take Baghdad. What a great idea. Now what are you going to do now that you took it? Well, let's destabilize the whole Mideast. Good idea. Who did that? The private sector? No. This was done with government deciding this is what we're going to do. We're going to bring democracy to these people that haven't had it in 1,000 years. We're going to show them what it's like. Well, guess what? Who's showing who? Go to an airport and tell me who's winning. Remember the days when O.J. used to run through when he was late for his airplane? Think about that. If you're not there 2 hours early, you ain't getting on the plane. Last month, we met with a major aviation company that is interested in expanding their operation here and potentially taking more than half of the first building. Later this month, we are meeting with another major aviation corporation that has expressed an interest in coming to Atlantic County. Now that the park appears to be real, it is generating strong interest. Now, I went to Baltimore years ago before, of course, the riots. That's taken a nosedive because of it. And when it was first done, the water area in Baltimore, the waterfront, and the Italian area, Little Italy, was about a block and a half long. Those of you who have been there, now it's 10, 12, 15 blocks all around. Why? Because success breeds success. People want to be there. We want people to come down here and be here. We want them to see what we have to offer. You know, when it snows, I want to go to Florida, but the change of season does have its benefits. In 2017, the Atlantic County Economic Alliance will begin a campaign to aggressively promote and market all of Atlantic County as a place to live, work, and recreate. We're also working to develop the Aviation Maintenance Training Institute here. The project is very significant because it will help us to realize the economic development potential of the airport. The goal is to have the training institute open by the end of this year, or even sooner. I'd like to thank Ira Weissman and Greg Durham, who have been spearheading this effort. Clearly, the year ahead looks very promising. As I said, we're not without opportunities. We are not unlike numerous other communities around. When the steel mills closed in Pittsburgh, it was all over for Pittsburgh, not yet. And I don't care where you go, a military base leaves somewhere. Everything, all is gone. Not true. You can pull yourself back up. Places like Dubuque in Iowa, places like Reno, Nevada, they did it for themselves. They helped themselves. We can do that here. And for those of you that want to walk away and say, is that my tax money? Is that what we hire county government officials to do? Well, yes, because if we don't do it, it's not going to get done. And that's what it comes down to. You want it done right? Do it yourselves. And nobody will tell me that the staff that I have that have brought Atlanta County through this mess that we've had can't do the job to make sure and expand out in economic development, because we can do it. And, you know, my staff is here, and I appreciate it, but much of the, where'd he go? Stand up, Howard. Stand up, Howard. You're fired, Howard. We know that, but they are, and I compliment them all the time, and I rarely compliment you. And I always said to me, with all my hard work, you charge me 3 days' pay. So that's how things work. But he really did spearhead this. I assigned Howard Cowell to this. I couldn't assign Ritalo or Del Rosso to this, because they have to run county government. They did real work, yeah, exactly. Plus, Howard gets free lunches, and of course, it didn't go unnoticed. And he is the one that spearheaded this, put it together, and I don't know what I would have done without him, because if I'm smart, I'm smart enough to pick the right people around me to get this job done, and I have. And I'm very, very proud of county government, everything they've done. Thank you so very much for your hard work, your short pay, and very little admiration because I don't want to spoil you. My staff, they knew it would be hard, and they knew it would take time, but we got it done. Atlanta County is on the same path, and I will assure that we, and by we I mean all of us, government, business, private citizens, will do the same. I want to thank you for your indulgence, and thank you so very much. I want you to be a part of this. If you have any ideas, please come to our meetings, let us know. The Freeholder Office, Frank Formica is here, the chairman. There are public meetings where you can come and speak, and you can come and see me. I mean, you're going to sit and talk to me in the public meetings. The press is there, they're on TV, so it is a place where you can vent or come up with your ideas. We'd be more than glad to hear from you and see you, and now I'm wrapping it up. But yeah, any questions, anybody? You want to get the hell out of here, don't you? I can see that. Well, thank you so very, very much once again. God bless you all.